Oh, we have a shrine. Okay. And who are you? You know, I gotta give him props. She is decidedly not busty. I don't know. Whenever I play these games, I'm just like, let me guess, the female characters are going to be ridiculously over busty. The answer is, huh, not in this case. I gotta respect that. Okay, so it's gonna be a while before we level up. We've got a decent amount of Amrita. We should be able to just retrieve that as we die. Okay, so she's with us. I don't know if we can... Oh. Okay, so we've lit the lamp. Is it... It looks like... looks like boss time. However, before we piss anything off, or before we fight the boss, we should probably take him out. Hopefully she doesn't... She does a lot more damage than I do. I wonder if it's, like, based on elemental damage. I'm not entirely sure. Either way, I'm gonna let her... probably do the damage on it. Yeah, that lightning damage does horrible things to these statues. If we're lucky, she's invincible, but I don't know. But yeah, ooh, interesting. Sneak attacks on these guys do extra damage. That's good to know. Yeah, I figured... Oh, she does take damage. I don't know how much, but she can and will. Okay, but yeah, I figure before we fight the boss, let's take out every single no good Nick hanging out in the area. Better than having a bad day when they suddenly just spring on me while we're trying to fight the boss. That's never a fun situation. Teamwork. Interesting. Okay, and we've got another one of the you guys. Oh, and we also have a friend there. Okay. I guess I'll check a bomb just so she doesn't get hit too much. There we go. Okay, I think this is the last of the living statues. I don't think they respawn. Oh! This isn't the boss. This is just a Oni. Ow. Not ow. Still scary. Please don't die, ninja chick. Yeah. Well. Hey, she's not dead yet. I gotta give her credit for face tanking like a champion. Though I gotta say, it's also really scary having a co-op partner that you can't coordinate with. And you can't tell if they're going to die, and also the enemies are really vaguely organized here. It'd be great if I actually had the ability to do, she failed? She is ashamed. Okay. I don't know if she's gonna die, and I don't know, like, what triggers, like, enemies switching between her and me. It almost seems like I'd automatically aggro them, but it's kind of inconsistent. I don't know. Well, I'll just keep befuddling over it. I feel like this entire level is the level of the what? The sorry, Digimon thing. Anyway, looks like we're safe again. Alright, now it's boss time. Maybe we should have gone back to the shrine. Oh, well. Is this the guy? Is this Munishige or whatever his name is?
Doing? 貴様、何者じゃ。船かというが、腐っても目男か。
Okay, it's our first human boss. Interesting. And worrying, and unfortunately now we don't have a co-op partner. Alright, so he's quick. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad thing. This might actually be one of the easier bosses I have to face here. He keeps his distance. As long as he keeps his distance and doesn't do anything pretty nuts, okay. That's a damage move. Okay. Ow. Yow. Wow. Okay. Yeah, so he burns his stamina pretty quick. But he can't... Oh, he's got a triple shot arrow thing. Okay, so I gotta watch out for when he charges me. I don't know if I can block. But still. Interesting question. What about poison? Okay, it doesn't look like I can poison him necessarily. I'm just gonna keep my distance, chuck this thing. I might be able to poison him, but I gotta have enough run-up time to do it. Okay, there we go. Looks like it's gonna be a bit costly trying to do it. Let's see. Yeah, I don't... It doesn't look like he's the variety that is going to get poisoned here. Well, that's unfortunate, but it also, it's fine. This might actually be one of the easier bosses I ever have to face. Ow. Okay, stay away from that. Heal up, because he can combo me and stun me pretty hard. Lucky thing is I can kind of stun him, I can kind of not. We'll see. I don't know how long my weapon's going to stay poisoned here. But I don't think we're going to be able to make much of a use of that. So I'm going to stay behind this pillar while I wait for my stuff to come back. We can also go into Musou mode. I know it's not Musou mode, it's spirit whatever mode, but still. Yeah, if he's going to do that run up. All right. Well, we might as well make the most of this while we have it. Now, do I have the, yeah, there it is. Oh, I can drag him around. Interesting enough. Didn't realize that. My spirit thing also seems to charge? I need to look into that. Let's just keep our distance from these combos. I mean, this is really probably going to be one of the easiest bosses I ever have to face. Can I just do it again? No, I can't. But I can do that, interestingly enough. It's not something I want to do often. But I can do it, and I can pull him into a combo. And kill him. Alright. Well, that was different. I was really weird. I really was not expecting a human boss to go down that easily, but he did. He was actually pretty easy to just kite around and beat the crap out of. Alright.
spirit guided me to the Amrita. I think it's time to move on now.
あの守護霊、お主にとって大事なものらしいな。お主が使った方が、この雷霧も喜ぼう。殿が異国に出兵した後、太后秀吉様がやってきました。太后様を拒み自害したとして、殿は、橘の民はどうなるのか。子を失いし我が身、この先長くはありますまい。しかし殿と力を合わせ民を守る、今はそれだけで嬉しゅうございます。
Okay, so we've been possessed by Raikin via Spirit Division. And supposedly now we got Raikiri, which might be an elemental sword that we can use. Which means if I do this again in co-op, I'm probably going to start using that sword almost consistently. Elemental damage could be really good against certain things. Or it could be complete garbage. I really have no way of knowing. Either way, that was the easiest boss battle I could have possibly run into. Anyway, Spirit Stone slumbers. Master Hanzo, I cannot thank you enough for your help, but unfortunately I cannot assist Lord Tokugawa. I would sooner take my own life than turn my back on the debt I still owe Lord Hideyoshi. Now, Sir Anjin, was it? Your skill with the blade is tremendous. Let me introduce you to my master, the finest tactician you will ever meet. Okay, so we get Raikiri, Spirit Stones, and some Machoko. That really actually wasn't that much of a reward for that, but whatever. Okay, so Mission Way of the Warrior Novice has been added to the dojo. Way of the Omyo Novice has been added to the dojo. Twilight Mission Squirming Sprite has been unlocked. Mission change to Twilight Mission. Okay, so we have a couple of things. We got Request from the Jinshio, Starting Point, and Proceed to Next Region. Oh, so we're kind of done with Chapter 1, interestingly enough. Actually found most of the little dudes. Well, let's start with the dojo first. Way of the Warrior Novice. Young Samurai Locks, Wooden Sword. Okay, so you're Sir Anjin, not a bad looking guy. Who am I, you say? I'm Marume Nagayoshi, the greatest soldier in the world. I've heard about you from Lord Munishige, tearing up bandits and yokai with techniques you picked up on your own. That's impressive stuff. How would you like to learn some real moves? Consider this your introduction to the Taisha School of Swordsmanship. You ready? Begin. Okay, so fair warning, I don't know how to pronounce Japanese stuff. Somebody was giving me a lot of shit for pronouncing Nioh incorrectly. Look, it's a foreign language that I am not fluent in. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to understand how to instinctively pronounce these things. And they're like, clearly you know nothing about the game if you can't pronounce it. And it's like, what does that even mean? Anyway, famed samurai locks. Locks of hair can be used to obtain various types of skill points. I guess we might as well use it. Does it give me 7? I wonder if these carry over. Probably not. Use the skill points to learn the skill option in the status menu. To learn a skill. So Learn skills. Which one? Sword key, presumably. You can switch which skills are assigned to which commands in the skill customization option. In the status menu. Okay. Oh, it wants me to do that. So, L1, triangle, guarding. Sword key. Disperses key from your sword to stun surrounding enemies. Huh. That's neat. I guess it wants me to actually switch it out for something. Or nothing? I'm not sure. Oh, we do have water shadow. Okay. That's actually pretty useful for group fights. I dig it. I'll have to use it more often. Alright, well that was fast. It'd be nice if we got to carry over those skill points, but I think they're tutorial focused only, which sucks, but also like it would be a little bit cheap, I don't know. Okay. So now that we've got that, now what? Oh yeah, there's the Omyo. I might as well do every tutorial available to us. Okay, nice work. That should give you something to work on for a while. No need to thank me. That fight taught me a few things about how you foreign samurai fight too. Either way, you're more than my disciples can handle. I'll spar with you myself next time. Look forward to it, Sir Anjin. I will be. Alright, so we've got a wooden sword and young samurai locks. I wonder if I could actually use that wooden sword. Probably. Anyway, yeah, we don't learn anything from these. So, let's do this one. Omyo, things. You honor me with your presence. By the way, Sir Anjin, have you any interest in the power of Omyo? Adding it to your existing strengths would surely make you the strongest, sharpest demon slayer of all. I am but a student of the arts myself, but if you wish, I will teach you what I know. An Omyo mage uses the flow of ki energy from the interplay of the dark and light to alter themselves, others, and the very nature of our world. It will surely be of use to you. Rightio. Oh, so we're here now. Okay. Well, it's not like these tutorials are very hard, but I might as well do them. I cut out the original tutorial mission with, like, at the very beginning of the game. I did it, but I didn't feel like showing it, just because tutorials are kind of boring. These are a little bit more interesting, because they're a little bit more complicated. Okay. So it wants me to use this. Locks of hair can be learned. Okay, we want to learn a skill. Which skill does it want us to learn? I must have missed it. Oh, yep, there it is. Okay, fire shot. Ready 3 fire shot talismans. Imbues your projectiles with the power of fire when used. Alright. Committee ninjutsu at the skill. Okay. Okay, so let's ready jutsu. Omega magic, fire shot. Can I do both? I can do both. Oh, right. It's because my spirit capacity is pretty high to begin with. Okay, and we want to equip it. Okay. Boop. Wow, that's actually pretty effective for fire damage. Well, that was easy. And we're done. Alright, so we might be able to keep this. I'll probably use the singular point into fire talisman or something like that, just so I can use it occasionally. Just because reusable elemental damage boost always seems like a good idea. I wonder if you can bolster the lightning damage of, like, Raikiri. Or not. I don't know. Interesting question. Alright, well, I've done some inventory management. Oh, right, I forgot. more important thing. Turns out, upgrading my, or bringing my equipment's levels up is really expensive, so I'm gonna nix that for a while. I might do it with, weapons that I can't easily replace, but for now, meh. Alright, so let's get that singular level in spirit. Well, I'd say that sucks, but at the same time, now we have access to every single upgrade here. And I should probably consider, switching. I like Daibawashi a lot. It's awesome. But at the same time, usable time varies. And might action, these are interesting. Okay. I'm read a gauge rate. I'd have to look into what specifically. Okay, so as much as I like Daibawashi, what's spirit protection do? Reduces damage taken across the board. That's a 20% damage taken. Oh, everybody has that though. Okay, yeah, so the reason why I'm not super interested in keeping with it, as great as it is, that luck plus 40 though, I don't know. Is Fuzuyoshi gives you flat 200 life. Poison doesn't matter too much. Guard key reduction, not that useful. Poison again, not that useful. Life recovery from Amrita absorption, though, is amazingly useful. Because that's going to be... that's going to net me a lot of... ooh, nah. The other option is Mizuchi. It's pretty good, too. Enemies defeated damage bonus. Let's try Mizuchi for the time being. Let's see if it's actually good. I don't know what that damage bonus looks like. No, you know what? Let's try Fuzuyoshi for the time being. I want to see how much HP we get going around. Anyway, so we got a side quest to try this out. So a request from Jinchio. Lady Jinchio sent a message to request that you accompany her personally on her search for a gift for Lord Munashige. Milady seems to have taken quite a liking to you. Please don't do anything uncouth and disappoint her. Okay, so these runes, located deep within the mountains, surrounded by sheer cliffs, are believed to have been constructed by a once-powerful clan. Even after the clan's demise, its great shrine and underground catacomb remain impressive, but with no one around to care for them, they have fallen into ruin, and now house nothing other than yokai. At this point, not even grave robbers are willing to approach it. Anyway, so we got Raikiri. Woo, this is different. Have I been here before? I have no idea if I've been here before. Anyway, I'm gonna pray for no other reason than because I can. Oh, she also has the same sword, but it's upside down compared to what I have it. That's funny, actually. Alright, I don't think I haven't been here. This is not a new location. Or, this is a new location. Okay, so we've got archers here. We've got multiple friends. Alright. Well, this will be interesting. It's also interesting that we have a co-op partner to work with. Her lightning damage was way higher than mine was. Which is a little bit disappointing, but alright, whatever. Yeah, I'm just... yeah. Can I break it? I can break it. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'm curious how much damage this thing will do. And I'm also curious fair amount. Unfortunately, I haven't taken any damage yet, so it's a little bit hard to exactly judge what's going on here. Also, a lot of level 40 people that are straight up dead here. Alright. Let's see. Just kind of keeping my distance here. I'm not sure what to expect. Oh, jeez. Just gonna piss him off with a headshot. I want to see if he'll roll that stone. Okay. He will roll that stone. Or, I don't know if we'll roll that stone, actually. At least his little buddies won't come and help immediately? Okay, this lightning effect is awesome. And I'm also really curious if she will die here. I don't know. Also, we lopped his limbs off. It's great. Okay, Prosperous Samurai has been earned.
Neat.
This is a weird sepia-toned level, too. How large is it? I know that we had that, like, cave down below, so that's something to look out for. We've also got these guys. Let's piss him off a bit. Well, or not. Ow, ow, wow. Okay, that hurt a little bit more than I thought it was going to. Okay. Yeah, so it looks like, looks like we get a decent amount of HP for kills here. That's awesome. I mean, I'm not entirely sure if it makes up for, I'm not sure if it makes up for the damage I take, but it will definitely, nah. It looks like just every time I gain an Amrita, it's 30 HP, just flat. It's not a conversion ratio, that's what it is. That might actually be a lot better than I gave it credit for. Because I'd like that damage bonus thing, probably. But just 30 HP every time I gain Amrita from anything. Like, I gain Amrita from hitting enemies. So, okay, so we got a boulder here. That's a goofy boulder animation if I ever did see one. Alright, what else do we got around here? We got some dead dude. I originally thought I'd be going down, but it looks like that's not the case. We've got something up here. I'm trying to make this kind of quick because we're going to be doing co-op fairly soon. Okay, so I can't go up there. She just broke it. Okay. Well, somebody died in front of this one. Nothing. Old charm. Alright, so we're done? Huh. Was not expecting that. Okay, so I can leave whenever I want now. That's useful. Let's go fight as many other things as we can. Yeah, so I might actually stick with Fuzuyushi here for at least some indeterminate amount of time. The ability to heal myself slowly. Oh, I see. There's just a bunch of treasure chests all over the place. And the point is we're supposed to search every location. I might also not take a whole lot of poison damage here. This could actually be a much bigger boon than I gave it credit for. Because, yeah, I liked my bird. The luck plus 40 is nice, but maybe... I mean, the fact the poison doesn't do anything to me screams useful. Alright, let's try going down. See what we got in the dank depths. I mean, yes, we're already done, but you never know. These are neat, though. I dig it. It's also really nice being just totally immune to poison. Okay. We're getting antidotes. Not exactly what I call the most useful thing in the world right now. But it'll be nice to stack them up. Yeah, if we know we're going to be up against a poison boss in an area. Wait, am I just not taking damage from anything? Okay, now I can grab it. Or is it because I've already... Am I not taking damage because I've already finished the level? That it would screw the game up? I have no idea. she's definitely taking damage. Okay, seriously? Yeah, she's not taking damage either. Alright. Well, seeing as she can't figure out how to get past a basic arrow trap, let's rescue her. Can I just run up here? Nope, can't. Alright. I also switched my helmet out, so I have the weird, dumb helmet mustache. I don't know. It's funny to look at. Here's a question. I should test this out. Cannot carry any more sacred brushes. Does this loop us back, or have I never been here before? My problem is I'm not entirely certain of where and who and what and whatever. Everything goes. Like, this is a much bigger level than it needs to be. Ish. Alright, let's try summoning a revenant. If I'm immortal past this point, can I summon a... Oh, I can't summon any revenants. Okay. So there might also just be no more enemies left either. Okay, well that's fine. Maybe I should just leave because the rewards aren't going to be very good either. Okay, was there anything else down this direction? Unfortunately, it's super dark in here. Should probably also consider switching my sword out, considering it's a bit on the noisy side. Yeah, hopefully she can figure out how to path to me, because I don't exactly feel like sticking around for too long. Did this lead anywhere? This leads back up. Let's check the pass, just because. I'm curious what other weird shenanigans I can get into. I didn't even think it would be possible that we'd have beaten the level so fast and that you actually take no damage past that point. I guess it's because they don't want to have, like, the end section. Kill you. Because that could be really bad. Okay, so where's this lead? Back into the catacombs. Possibly where we were just in? Maybe a different section. Oh, yeah. Looks like this leads to one of the sections of the catacombs that I must have missed. Are we even getting anything good? Yeah we are. We just got 3 Achoko cups. Okay. I will accept that. Oh, I see. So this would have been where I would have gone had I turned that one direction, but instead... Yeah, so I know it's a bit of a, what am I gonna say? A bit of a drag just wandering around, but at the same time, like, Achoko cups are super rare, comparatively. Like, I think I had, like, 5 or 6, give or take. And so if I can get a couple, I think we're good. Unfortunately, I think we're also done. Well, that's fine. Doesn't look like there's... Oh, yeah, there's just a little bit of treasure in here. Yeah, wow, we lucked out. I wonder if there are normally enemies supposed to spawn in these locations. But because I finished the level, they all despawn too. Well, one way or another, not gonna look the gift horse in the mouth. Let's get out of here. So that is it for chapter 1 of the game, or at least this region. Because after this, we go on to a new region, but I think I'm gonna do co-op stuff first. So I don't know if it's going to be a, Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Well, co-op. I'm just considering how to put up all this footage. Honestly, oh, hello. Lady Ginchio is delighted, but it seems she gave the present not to Lord Munishige, but to his mistress, Lady Yachiko. I wonder what it could have been. Milady's behavior is quite beyond me at times. Okay, so we got smithing text, Raikiri, and some other stuff. That's useful. And we did unlock a new one. Invitation from the Warrior of the West. Oh. If I remember right, this is the boss that just kicked my ass. Alright, whatever. Let's level up at the very least. So I could keep putting points into strength. It helps my defense, and if I can get it up to 13, we can max out the dragon thing, which is tempting. I could also put points into skill or dexterity or whatever. Doesn't really make as much of a difference as you'd think. Yeah, alright. Just a little bit more spirit. One more point, and then we'll be done, and then I'll probably start putting points back into stamina or whatever. But I mean, it's not like I'm feeling particularly weak here. But still, okay. Yeah, I have no magic that I can do. Well, that's fine. Yeah, so I could try fighting the Warrior for the West. Maybe I could even have a fair shot at it now that I've got the Kusari Gama. But I don't know. Anyway, yeah, I think what I might actually do is have my co-op footage be interspersed between chapters. So before we go on to the next region, I'll run co-op. And I think what I'll do is organize with Keith that every time we beat a region, then we'll get together to do co-op as kind of like a fun revisit everything and kick ass. I'm not entirely sure. We'll figure it out. Either way, I'll see you guys on the next episode of Nioh. And as always, thanks for watching.